be it right there. It could be done. It could be all over and done with.
Wait a second. Billy Madison just took out Silly
Billy. Here's a numbers game.
Here comes Warhead.
Here's a numbers game. It's coming out here. And I'm gonna take off my stash and put myself down. And I'm gonna go in there right now.
You gotta stay here.
This is a numbers game. This is the kind of stuff that the Secret Society is known for and United is trying to do. You gotta take a man out one-on-one. You try to take him when he's down. And it's pathetic. Pathetic like you are, Mr. Black.
Oh, United!
Oh! Splashes that knee. Much like he did to Biggie Biggs' arm.
Okay, I'm going in there.
All right. Justice Garrison making the save. I don't know. Oh, man. I think they just took Silly Billy out. I don't know if he's gonna be able to walk after that. Wait a second, he just stole the belt!
Ooh, Big Rick, just because you have a belt doesn't make you champion, baby. I saw you steal that from my boy Silly Billy, and I tell you what, Silly Billy, baby, Biggie Biggs is gonna go out on a limb, and he's gonna go face that Big Rick, and I'm gonna hit him with a BOOM! Big ups, and bring that belt back to you, Silly Billy, because it's still your belt, Silly Billy, not yours, Big Rick. Bad Big Rick, newspaper next time. So tonight, Big Rick, all kidding aside, baby, the Chop Daddy Biggie Biggs is coming for you for one reason, and one reason only, is to put an end to your nonsense, your hatred, and your beating down on my boy, Silly Billy.
All right, big, we put Silly Billy out for good. You don't have to deal with that guy anymore. Yeah, that's a pretty nice subs. Anyway, we don't have to deal with Silly Billy anymore, so that's a great thing. Put him on the shelf, out of my hair. Beautiful, he's gone. He's not coming back. No, he's not coming back. Leg snap. No, I ordered you guys to snap his leg, and like a twig, we snapped it. So now, yeah, he has a friend.
Do you know who his friend is?
Big Bird. All right. But for the idiots at home, that's Biggie Biggs.
There he is.
He's a pretty big guy, pretty heavy. Anyway.
Almost reminds me of Snuffleupagus.
Yes.
There it is.
Very true. Yeah. Anyway, that guy, he's getting in our business. And I don't like it when guys get into United business. Right? So we're going to have to take care of him once and for all. Tell them what you're going to do to them.
What am I going to do to Biggie Biggs?
Yes.
Biggs, listen, you showed up, you shot your mouth off yet again in business that you don't even care about. What are you worried about? You've wrestled your great matches, all right? You've had your great moments in the indies. Stop. Go home.
Ranger Nick.
You call him Ranger Nick?
Yes.
All right, that might be gimmick infringement, but it's okay. Listen, Nick, go home. We don't want you here anymore. I run the UWC. We run the UWC. We're the United, and you're just washed up. I'll see you out there, Nick.
Wrestling fans, and welcome to another exciting edition of UWC Championship Wrestling. I'm Chris Wilcox. We have another great action-packed episode for you this week. You're going to see Rude Boy Riley go one-on-one with the Scottish Suplex Specialist, Ryan Haston. And our big main event, I can't wait for this one, you're going to see Biggie Biggs go one-on-one with the Big Rig in a big grudge match. Now, we showed you at the top of the program what happened last month at the UWC Arena. Silly Billy had just beaten the Big Rig to retain the UWC Heavyweight Championship. And all of a sudden, from behind, here comes the United with the sneak attack. They target that right knee. They take him out of action. And then to add insult to injury, they stole that UWC Heavyweight Championship belt. Well, Biggie Biggs, that was not okay with him at all. He wanted a shot at the Big Rig. He made the challenge that night. And we're going to have that match for you on this week's episode of UWC Championship Wrestling. He's not the only one that has something to say about what happened last month. UWC's interim commissioner, Scott Volk, he has a couple of announcements regarding what happened last month between Silly Billy, the United, and the Big Rig. And then he has a big announcement for our March event at the UWC Arena in Browns Mills. This is some big news. Let's get to the ring right now for what Scott Volk has to say.
UWC Commissioner, Interim Commissioner Scott Volk has some things to say.
No one cares.
This is my role as the official Interim Commissioner of
UWC. I was heard you should pay attention to some of these.
No, you don't need to pay attention to none of these.
The UWC is happy to announce that the Board of Directors will not be stripping Silly Billy of his heavyweight title while he recuperates from his injury.
$1,000, then
the United's bank account goes deep.
You better hope so.
Next month, as announced earlier, UWC will be celebrating its 14th anniversary.
Sit down, Chris Wilcox.
I like the UWC.
I hate this place. Suits. Oh, man. Really?
To make the evening most interactive in UWC history.
Really? We're doing this?
The show will give you, the fans, the opportunity to pick some of the matches as well as some of the stipulations.
Fan interaction. That's what we need more of.
We need less of that.
Also on Saturday, March 10th, the 2011 year in the World Winners will be announced. And finally, and this is my favorite announcement, after an exhaustive search, the UWC Board of Directors is anticipated on making a major announcement regarding the next UWC Commissioner.
Now you should pay attention to that, Chris Wilcox.
I don't think it's you. Here for singles action, Ryan, the Scottish Suplex Specialist Haston, going one-on-one with Rude Boy Riley. I'm joined here on commentary by the manager of the Secret Society, Mr. Black.
Well, thanks, Wilcox, for having me, I guess. We got Rude Boy Riley here against Ryan, the Black-hearted Haston, and whatever else you called him, I don't know.
The Scottish Suplex Specialist.
Yeah, say that.
Nice!
That was just a waist lock, not a suplex.
No, that was not a suplex. That does not count as one. He's got him in the waist lock on the ground. Rude Boy trying to get out of this. And so far with no success. But there we go. He's got back up to a vertical base here.
Austin's got a little bit of size on him. Not too much.
The straight edge superstar from the slums of Shaolin, that's Rude Boy Riley, has not yet picked up that first win here in the UWC, but he's looked very impressive in the few times we've seen him. I think it's only a matter of time before we see him pick up that first win. And there's a vertical suplex, that's number one.
Well, I think Rude Boy's going to take a powder over there on the apron and figure out what he's going to do to get that elusive victory you've been talking about.
That was a very rude suplex.
You know, I went up to this guy before the show, went to shake his hand, and he shook my hand.
What?
I guess that's why he's Rude Boy.
He just choked him on the ropes right there. That is a little rude. The man lives up to his name. It's truth in advertising. But
well, he's certainly not a fan favorite here at the UWC. An elbow right to the back of the head of Haston.
There's a couple blows to the lower back. Last month we saw him one-on-one competition against Warhead. Chopped to the back. Following up by the Rooter splash right there, and the drop kick right to the head.
That boot went right to the face of Haston. He should go for the cover right now. He might be able to get the pin.
One, two, only it's a count of two.
That took a little bit too long there. A little too early to get Haston on the three count after that big long win.
Now we saw Rude Boy Riley here last month, very close to beating Warhead, until Philly Madison got involved, distracted the referee, distracted Rude Boy, and he got locked in that Shinomaki hole and did not pick up the win.
Leg drops to the back of the neck, sends Haston face first into the mat, over the cover.
Two, only good for a count of two.
That was a lot closer. Rude Boy's got to follow up. He's got Haston reeling.
He's in the ropes right there with some right hands to the midsection. Both these men coming off losses. Both men want to pick up a victory to get back in the title hunt here in the UWC. This is the clothesline. And that's number two.
Coming back, suplex into a slam and a fake splash. And somewhere Garrison pops.
Number only good for a count of two.
Only a two count.
Rude Boy Riley showing a little bit of resiliency in there. Getting picked up here for another vertical suplex, but blocked.
Big punch and then a punch from the midsection. Riley going now.
Off the ropes. Swinging neck breaker, very nicely done. Needs to go for the cover though.
Yeah, that's two or three times he's hit Haston and worked on the neck.
That might be the inexperience of Rude Boy Riley.
What the heck is that?
That's the skank and destroy elbow drop.
Well, that was kind of rude, I gotta admit.
Goes for the cover, only good for a count of two.
If he had gotten a pin on that, I think Haston would have suplexed everyone in this building.
May very well have.
I hope he suplexes you one day.
Let's hope that doesn't happen for the sake of UWC Championship Wrestling. Now Haston coming back with some right hands in the midsection.
Big right hand right to the jaw.
Jacking some jaws right there.
Kick to the midsection, has Riley reeling.
Short arm into a T-bone, number three.
Let's go,
Haston getting all fired up here.
And the crowd, they're getting on their feet right here. Haston gonna whip him off the ropes. This is the clothesline.
And the big leg hits it. Belly to belly, overhead, suplex.
Number four. That's going to do it right there, I believe.
Well, now he's got to pull Rude Boy back into the ring. That's too much time.
Only a count of two. That was some good, almost veteran-like instincts by Riley, getting close to the rope, making him drag him towards the center of the ring. That may have been enough to cause him to get the win.
Not a fan of either of these guys, Wilcox, but they're putting on a heck of a match here to start off the show.
Sizing him up right here, just giving him a super kick.
You're going for that big boot.
Misses it.
Duck.
And that kick right there, right to the chest. Goes for the cover. Two. Almost a count of three.
Wow, that was close.
You're not going to get any closer than that. Rude Boy Riley almost picked up his first win here in the UWC.
I'm telling you, if he hooked the leg, he would have had him. That was so close. He could have beat him. But
now he's letting it get in his head. He's arguing with Scott Boke. He needs to follow up on Haston. He could almost get the pin right here.
Rude and rude. And a big forearm smash to Haston.
Whips him into the corner. Reversed.
Haston charges. Boot catches him right in the sternum.
He dies and he got caught.
Look at the power of Ryan Haston.
Oh.
He's got him up on his shoulders.
Is he going to go for the Haston hammer? There it is. One, two, three.
You can count to ten. Impressive victory by Ryan Haston.
The Scottish Suplex Machine. Specialist. And he's signaling he wants a shot at that UWC television title.
Well, Haston's finally coming to his own in singles wrestling here in the UWC. And any month now, I wouldn't be surprised to see him challenge for a singles title. Oh, that makes me sick.
Wait a second, I don't think he sees the orphans in the ring.
I don't know if he sees them right now, but... Oh, kick to the back of the knee!
Oh, what's Orphan doing? He's going for that slop drop right there.
And hits it!
Speaking of rude, the Orphan... We saw a little bit of this last month. It looks like the Orphan wants another shot at Ryan Haston.
He's taking his time over the fallen body of Haston.
What's he doing?
He's writing something on his forehead. I can't see from this angle.
It's a big X. It's a giant X. What the heck is that for?
I think I know what that means. That's what Billy Lasseter puts on his head.
Well, Billy Lasseter's not here.
What are you saying, Orphan? Come on, Orphan.
Well, you know, Orphan's been overlooked for a long time here in the UWC, and apparently he's having none of it.
Wait a second. The Orphan making an impact here. What's he doing?
Right?
Is he gonna...
He's got that marker again, and he just threw the X on his own forehead.
And now he's putting it on Haston's forehead. He's putting that X, that Billy Lasseter X, right on the forehead of Ryan Haston.
Oh, I think he just branded Ryan Haston as a member of the Unholy Alliance. Wait, here comes the Rude Boy again.
Orphan getting, hightailing it out of there.
Orphan walking away with a sly grin on his face.
Austin's just been branded by the Orphan. Competition. This is a grudge match main event. Biggie Biggs going one on one with the Big Rig. Biggie Biggs coming for revenge after what Big Rig did to Big Silly Billy just a month ago. Big Rig walking around with that UWC heavyweight title belt pretending that he earned it. He lost to Silly Billy clean as a sheet last month. He does not, he is not the UWC heavyweight champion. It's already been announced that they're not going to strip him because of the way that he was injured. So we got a singles match here, two big goals going at it. Biggie Biggs in the big one. Kicks him in the midsection right there. Overhead blows right to the upper back area, trying to work on Biggie Biggs here. And he's trying to muscle up his hair, now he's driving those elbows into the skull. Sizing him up right there with the big right hands. And there's Big Rig jawing with referee George Banaha. Sizing him up. Ooh, big right hand. Big Rig showing off those guns right there. But he's not paying attention. You can't do that against Biggie Biggs. He's too good. He's one of the best wrestlers here in UWC, and UWC history, actually. He just caught a big kick. He's got chopped right across the back. Thrown into the turnbuckle here. I think he's tuning in Tokyo right now. He looks like he's just unbuttoning his shirt. Oh, he just took it. Another big chop. Oh, there it is. There's the big chop across the chest. Oh, and now he's tuning in Tokyo. Looks like he's getting a good reception right here. Big Rig reeling after that succession of moves, and there's a big right hand. kick right to the knee. Taking control right here against the Big Rig. Couple of big bulls just going right at him. Big Rig asking for mercy, does not deserve any after his actions of late. And he's got thrown in the turnbuckle. Big Rig, ever the snake in the grass. Well, now he's distracting the referee. There's textbook Billy Madison. You can see he's choking away right there at Biggie Biggs. United taking control here. Now he's got him in that big hammer lock right there. Now he's taking control over there. He's trying to work on that arm. Remember, it was about a year ago, Big Rig, with his partner Bubba from CB4, they injured Biggie Biggs' arm. He was supposed to miss some time, he didn't. But there's a history there. Crowd rallying behind Biggie Biggs. Right to the midsection, and another one. Make it three, and goes right to the eyes. Doesn't let him have control for too long. Now choking him in the ribs. Look at this Big Rig. And there you see textbook Billy Madison choking away on the ropes. Almost like a two-on-one handicap match right here for Biggie Biggs. Right hands right there to the side of the face. Driving that elbow right across the the upper back. Now he's using the ropes. We don't know if that arm ever really truly healed after what happened. He tried to keep wrestling, but he made a lot of successful title defenses with the arm injured. And there's Billy Madison driving that book across the arm. Now kicking away. Going back to work on the arm. Right back to the arm. Trying to take control here. Now hits him with some right hands in the midsection. And there's the chop. More. It's like being hit with a catcher's mitt. With a double boot, gets Biggie down. He's calling that a drop kick. Very much aided by the ropes. Now he's wrapping that arm in the ropes right there. Big Rig is just a terrible, just an opportunist. Look at the chest of the Big Rig. You can see, I think I see some blood on that chest. That's the kind of damage those chops can do. Kicking away at the head. More kicks. Look at the arrogance of the Big Rig. You can't be like that against Biggie Biggs. You're giving him time to get back to his feet. Oh, look at that right hand. He gave Biggie too much time. Now Biggie's back up. He hits him with a big elbow. And another chop. Hits him off the ropes. Biggie bomb! Biggie bomb in the center of the ring, that's it! Two! Big Rig got up! Oh my goodness, wait a second. X-Ray Stevens trying to get to the ring. Secret Society trying to keep him away. X-Ray Stevens, he wants a piece of Biggie Biggs. Biggie Biggs distracted. Hits him with that elbow. Sidewalk Bulldog slam, what strength by the Big Rig, goes for the cover. Big Rig wins. What a huge win for the Big Rig. He just pinned Biggie Biggs. Wait a second, X-Ray Stevens. He wants to get a hold of Biggie Biggs. Look at this. Chaotic scene right here. The Secret Society trying to keep Biggie Biggs away from the ring. Insulted. He wants X-Ray Stevens. They don't want it. They don't want him to take the match. Oh, X-Ray wants the match. Next month, right here, March 10th, X-Ray Stevens versus Biggie Biggs.